Thank you, everybody. I really appreciate it. This is a big honor for me to be here. I'm drawn to the Burtons, and I'm drawn to all of you and to the RBTV camp because I'm drawn to the four pillars, which are love, peace, patience, and humility. And like many of you, I can tell you that these pillars for me are ideals. They're goals that I strive for, but there's no way that I achieve these goals or the living up to these ideals every single day. I'm gonna talk a little bit about the theme of this year's RBTV camp, and then I'm also gonna share with you a prayer that I like that's been helpful to me that I'm gonna pass out at the very end. The theme is the King in me, the call to greatness. You can hold this in front of you, just keep it in front of you and reflect on it. And all of you who have the opportunity to be part of RBTV this coming year, I'd like for you to sort of carefully study your mission statement and really be ready to go. So the first of these words is king. When the ordinary world thinks of a king, they think of a person who is wealthy and powerful, someone who stands above others and does not necessarily have to listen to the opinions or the thoughts or the needs of others. But as all of you know, that is not the king we seek to be. The king we seek humbled himself by taking the form of an ordinary carpenter. And he lived as part of a very simple family that inhabited a small town in ancient Israel. This is Jesus. He knows well the RBTV four pillars. He is humble. He loves others. He is always patient, thank goodness for all of us. He's always patient with us. And he always brings peace to every situation. The king that we all need to find inside of us is the king that is not recognized in our everyday world. Our king does not want us to live by the unwritten rules of our everyday world. Our king wants us to be a true friend to others. He wants us to be true to ourselves and our bodies. He wants us to be a good son under all circumstances, to seek quiet time to pray, to be a good student, and to stand up for others who are left out or isolated because of differences. The next word I'd like to examine is greatness at the other end of our phrase. Martin Luther King once said, and I'm paraphrasing his quotation, "The example of Jesus is that if you want to be great, you must serve others." This is wonderful news because it means that everyone can be great because all of us can serve others. In other words, we all can be great because we all can serve. We all want to be great. It is a struggle every day, every single day, to be humble, to be patient. But being truly great means that we serve others at all times. We serve our parents, we serve our teammates, we serve our fellow students. We serve our brothers and sisters even when we cannot stand the sight of them. It sounds so simple, but we all know how hard it is. And believe me, I know how hard it is. I get caught up every day in what the world thinks is great. I know it is hard for you to believe, but many of us know the pressures and difficulties that all of you young men face every day. I have to tell one quick story if I can. So my 14-year-old Tomas, his name is Tomas Ricardo O'Brien. It's one of my favorite things to say. He's a Latino kid with an Irish surname. He could easily be mayor of Boston someday. When he was about 9 years old, he looked at me and he said, "Dad, did you grow up to be exactly what you wanted to be when you were my age?" So imagine that, all you parents in the room. And I had the presence of mind to immediately look at him and say, "Yes, when I was 9 years old, I absolutely wanted to be a commercial real estate developer." And he looked at me, actually believed me, and he started to walk away. I said, "No, Tomas, I wanted to play for the Boston Bruins, or I wanted to play for the Boston Red Sox, or that's what I wanted to be when I grew up." And so I think of that story all the time because I had no idea where my life would take me. But the truth of my life is I've thought carefully about my reputation and who I am, and I've tried as best I can to think about showing the outward signs of Jesus' teaching every day. I fail often, fail frequently, I fail all the time, But that piece has fed my reputation and has helped me develop a sense of discipline, which has helped me in my life. And I hope that all of you young men can think about that as well. So the next word to look at is call. The important thing to remember is that we are called every day, but God knows that we don't always achieve the ideals of the call. He knows that there are days or weeks or months at a time that we are not great in the eyes of God. But we must remember that He will take us back every single time. St. Paul tells us that nothing we do can separate us from the love of God. That no matter how far you may wander from the teachings of Jesus, you can always find your way back. So just remember that you are called. So last, I'd like to take two remaining words together, and they are the words in me. In me. We are referring to the fact that the King is in you. Whether you know it or not, whether you feel it or not, He is in you. And so we capitalize the I in the word in out of respect for the King. And the important word here among these two is the word in, not me. The King is in you. You have it. Just seek it, find it, and display it. So here's the most important lesson from tonight. You are a king in God's eyes. God knows what you can be, and He is cheering you on. Believe me, He wants you to be all that you can be. You also need to know that you are a king in the eyes of all the people here. The people here, the Burtons, your family, we believe in you. Be the king that God wants you to be. The king of love, the king of peace, the king of patience, and the king of humility.
Mr. O'Brien's speech, that really helped me understand how things work. People can make mistakes, but you have to forgive them. He gave us a new way of seeing the world, like how people would think a king would be and how the king really is. He is always helping people. He's not just a selfish person.
I learned a lot. Well, he was talking about the king in me, the call to greatness, and he was explaining how some people think of a king as like someone that can't take other people's opinions. And he was saying how Jesus is different in that he accepts us sinning and he forgives us and has humility, peace, patience, and love.
That was probably one of my favorite speeches that I've heard in a while. The prayer that he showed us resonated with me incredibly. It focuses on the fact that we don't know if we're doing what God wants us to do, but the desire that we have to please Him, should please Him, that is incredible. I never thought about it in that sense. And as soon as he said it, it hit goosebumps all over my body. All over my body. It was incredible. It was an incredible thing. And now I'm walking away with a different view on things. It helps me understand the scripture even more now. Because how could we know what He wants? Because He is so perfect. He is so above our level of thinking that it's too difficult to comprehend. But if we desire to please Him, if the desire is there, we can accomplish it. And that, to me, I've never thought about it like that, and it's eye-opening.
His prayer that he brought to us this evening was very, very poignant to every single kid in that room. And what they're going through and what they're going to go through in life in the summer and the run. And, you know, he hit it. He really hit. I was expecting to hear, you know, the story of his life and where it took him and how he became successful. And his whole talk just resonated with every single person in the room.
Tom really prepared and he gave a lot of thought to the lesson that he was going to give. And I think it really came through that he was trying to impart some wisdom